Now, types of network topology. The next one is the ring topology. As you can see, the layout of the computer network is in the form of a ring. Now, on a ring network, a cable forms a closed loop or a ring with all computers and devices arranged along the ring. It's a pictorial representation. It clearly gives the computers are connected in the form of a ring in one direction. It can be either in clockwise direction or it can be in the anti-clockwise direction. It is called unidirection. One direction is possible. Data transmitted on a ring network travels from device to device around the entire ring in one direction. In one direction means unidirection, either clockwise or counterclockwise, anti-clockwise. When a computer or device sends data and data travels to each computer on the ring until it reaches its destination. Token passing is nothing but when people give you tokens. For example, when you are in queue, you'll be given tokens. The first one who comes gets the first token, so he will be served first, followed by the next one, followed by the third one. That is called as token passing. A classical example would be attendance taken in class. The class teacher calls out the first roll number first, followed by the second one, followed by the third one. That is called as token passing. Token means it is in the sequential form. One, followed by the second one, followed by the third one, so on and so forth. So token passing is one method for sending data around a ring. Each device takes a turn sending and receiving information through the use of a token. That is 1, 2, 3. The token along with any data is sent from the first device to the second device, which extracts the data address to it and adds any data it wishes to send. Then second device passes the token and the data to the third device, etc., until it comes back around to the first device again. As I told you earlier, when you have four computers, when the layout is like a ring, the data transmission is from first to the second, and from the second it moves to the third, and from the third it moves to the fourth, and from the fourth it finally comes to the first one. The reason behind it is, since it is in the form of a ring, the first computer cannot communicate with the third computer or the fourth computer, because it has to travel computer 3 and 4 through computer number 2. Hope this is clear to you. So it is in a sequential form. When it is in clockwise form, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Or if it is in anti-clockwise form, it is 4, 3, 2, 1, and finally 4. Only the device with the token is allowed to send data. All other devices must wait for the token to come to them. As I have clearly told you in the previous example, this is the clockwise model. So computer number 1, if it has to communicate to computer number 3, it has to communicate to computer number 2. And then only it can communicate to computer number 3. Hope this is very, very clear. It is the clockwise model, unidirectional ring topology, or the layout of the network is in the form of a ring. Signals are sent around the network from node to node. If a node is faulty, then there must be a method of bypassing the failed node. An example is when you have a power supply, when the power is down, you will switch on the UPS. So UPS, you can make use of the power. That is the bypassing technique. If the bypassing technique is adopted, there won't be any issue in that. If it is not there, then the communication channel fails, and finally the network will also fail. Hope this is clear to you. What are the advantages? The transmission of data is relatively simple, as packets travel in one direction only. Packet is nothing but the smallest form of a data is called as a packet. Cable faults are easily located, making troubleshooting easier. Troubleshooting means a trouble is solved, resolved. That is, shooting a trouble is called as troubleshooting. Resolved is called as troubleshooting. The uses of token passing enables all devices in a ring topology to share the network resources fairly. As you are quite aware, token passing is nothing but one followed by the second one followed by the third one, as I have already given you the example of attendance. Disadvantage: a failure in any cable or device breaks the loop and can take down the entire network. Data packets must pass through every computer, therefore this makes it slower. So data transmission is relatively slower. So a ring network can span a larger distance than a bus network, but it is more difficult to install. So installation part is very difficult. That is the disadvantage. Now next we move on to the star network. As you can see, the hub or the switch is placed right in the middle. As you can see, the wires are in the form of a star model. In the next slide, I'll show it to you very clearly. Now here, all peripheral nodes are connected to a central node. Central node is nothing but the switch or the hub. If a peripheral node fails, it has no effect on the network. If the centralized node fails, the whole network is down. That is, if there is a problem in the switch or the hub, which is kept right in the middle, then the whole network will be down. The advantage is easy to add new stations. Disadvantage is central node may get congested with network traffic. When you add more and more computer, the processing speed will be less, and there is a possibility of this switch may be malfunctioning. That is the greatest disadvantage. The point here is, when the switch or the hub has a problem, then the total network will be down. But if one computer is not functioning, that will not bring any problem to the network. That is the ultimate idea that you have to understand in star topology. Advantages: if one device fails, only that particular device is affected. As I have mentioned it earlier, if one device fails, one computer has a problem, then it is left to that particular computer alone. It has nothing to do with the network. Devices can be added to or removed from network with little or no disruption. So you can easily add or remove a computer in the network. Easy to troubleshoot and isolate problem. So you can resolve the issues easily when it is a star network topology. Disadvantage: if the hub or switch fails, the entire network will be inoperable. That is, it will not function. Required more cable than most of the other topologies. More expensive because the cost of the hub or switch. So hub and the switch, which is expensive when compared to the ring topology or the bus topology, because ring topology and bus topology, they do not have this concept of hub. So they don't have to buy the hub for ring and the bus topology, but for star topology, compulsorily you should buy a hub or a switch. Now we will move on to the mesh topology. As you can see the picture, in the picture, the top picture has four computers. As you can see, four computers are connected to one another with wires. As you can see, the below one, it has five computers. As you can see, all five computers are connected to one another with the help of cable. So here the problem is, you need more and more cable so that The first computer can communicate directly to the fifth computer, fourth computer, and third computer. But in ring topology, that is not possible. Because in ring topology, as you know, it has to, the first computer has to communicate to second one, followed by the third one, and then followed by the fourth one when it is in a clockwise form. But in mesh topology, here, as more cable is involved, any computer can connect to any other computer. The data can be sent easily. That is the advantage of a mesh topology. In mesh topology, every node is connected with every other node in the computer. Because of dedicated point-to-point connection between every possible pair of nodes, the topology provides secure data transfer without any traffic problem. Traffic problem is nothing but easily the data when it can be transmitted from one to another, there won't be any queues. So token, that form of problem will not come in mesh topology. It requires a large number of connection establish the topology. This leads to difficulty in installation as the number of nodes grow as the network grow. If you want to add another computer there on the second picture, again you have to give connection to all the other computers. So it is a difficulty in installation. That is for mesh topology. And finally, tree topology. As you can see here, tree is nothing but the combination of bus and star topology. As you can clearly see in this picture has a main cable right in the middle. A vertical line is dividing those two hubs and switches. I have clearly given you here the main cable here. That main cable is an example of the bus topology. And you also have four star topology, two on the left hand side and two on the right hand side. So altogether it is four star topology and one ring topology. So tree topology is equal to one bus and the collection of star topology. So it is the combination of two topologies. Tree is equal to a bus topology and collection of other star topology as well. So that is the biggest advantage. The tree topology is a hybrid topology using combination of star and bus topology. In this model, there is one bus topology which is given very clearly right in the middle, a vertical line that is flowing, which is the bus topology, and four star topologies are given. So it is the connection of four star topology and one bus topology. Backbone cable in a bus topology act like the stem of the tree, and star topology and even individual nodes are connected to the main backbone cable like the branches of the tree. That is, if you could take a tree, the stem is here, we are going to relate that stem as the bus topology, which is right in the middle. It is acting as a stem for the tree, and the star topology, the four star topology, we are relating it to the branches of the tree. So there is only one stem, but you can have as many branches as you can. So the tree topology is very, very clear to you. Third point, damage to a segment of a network laid using tree topology will not affect other segments. For example, there are totally four star topologies here. If one star topology fails, that has nothing to do with the others. It will not affect the other network because star topology 2, star topology 3 and star topology 4 along with the main cable of bus will function on its own. That is the biggest advantage of tree topology. And fourth point, installation and configuration is difficult as compared to other topologies because this is the hybrid model. So when you are installing and configuring, it is little difficult. Also, if the backbone cable is damaged, the entire network communication is disrupted. as the real life example, as we are considering it as a tree, the stem is equal to the bus topology. When there is a breakage in the stem, then finally there will be a problem in the network. So main cable or the bus topology, which is acting as the stem of the tree, is very, very important. If there is any breakage to the stem, that is the bus topology, if there is any breakage in the bus topology, the entire network will be down. That is the precautionary measure that has to be taken when you are using the tree topology.